Hello.
We are here. Love. Are you there? Hello. We are here. Love. Are you there? Hello. We are here. Love. Are you there? Hello. We are here. Love. Are you there? Hello, we are here. Love, are you there? Hello, we are here. Love, are you there? Hello, we are here. Love, are you there? Love, 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 love.
The human brain is 90% dormant. This dormancy now can be self-released. This is the brain revolution. Center of the universe. This is a human brain. It's his. This was my teacher. This was the guy that taught me when I went to ask him the question at the university, hey, why did I have to kill my brother during World War II? And he said, look, we don't know the answer. It has something to do with the human brain, and that research hasn't been done yet, so therefore you're going to have to go out and do it yourself. Okay, so dropped out, came up here. Got the place first, and then started learning about this thing. Now, this is the back part. This is the cerebellum, this part that controls the muscles. Here are the occipital lobes where you get your eyesight from, your various other sensors. And then just about in the middle here where the motor strip is, that's about the limits of what we know everything about. But from here on in, underneath this dura mater, this shock absorber, here are the frontal lobes. This is everything from your ears to your eyebrows. These are the magical frontal lobes. Experimentally, this is where all the mystics report the next stage of evolution is. This is the frontal lobes experience, the nirvana experience, Satori, Kensho, Moksha, born again. It happens up here. When Saul was walking on the road to Damascus, he became Paul right there. If you put your two fingers into your ears, where they would meet inside is the amygdala. Now, the amygdala is a click switch. It can click from your old root stem in the back into your frontal lobes. It also can click from your left hemisphere, logical, verbal thinking, to your right hemisphere, artistic, nonverbal thinking, so that you can learn by an act of will to click your amygdala into four power positions.
The whole point of this program is to be able to eventually self-control clicking from one hemisphere to the other, or into two or four, three or four at once.
The whole thing is backward self-therapy and then forward self-circuiting into the brain, into the rest of the brain, the dormant brain.
The one thing that was the most impressive to me was that as I was doing my therapy, when I was under really intense therapy, every time I came out with a really good psychodrama and really strong emotions and resolved it to a completed act, I would experience a paranormal happening.
One morning I got up and I just sort of got up and stretched and came out and I started looking around and I realized it was like my vision was microscopic. I was seeing the cells and the leaves on the plants. I was seeing flies, or there was a bee walking up my arm, and I was seeing all the cells in its wings and all the hairs on its legs, and everything was in the most incredible detail. Now this is amazing because I wear glasses and I'm rather nearsighted, so things like that sort of pop in on me. I'm hoping to be able to do that more at will with time.
And pretty soon, from the back of my head, these two fine little wires of energy kept going finer and finer all the way until it got to my frontal lobes, and then it just bam!
Another time I was meditating, I'm not sure if it was on my hippocampus or my amygdala or in that general area, and I actually saw... It's eidetic vision, but it's not really, because I was looking into my brain. I was seeing my brain, and I could see the folds of the cortex, and it just, I knew I was looking at my own brain. I was seeing a brain, and it was mine, and you can believe it or not, but I do.
Once one has learned that the brain is a mechanical instrument, then you can learn to control the mechanics of it in just exactly the same way you control your automobile. This is something that everybody can do. The point is that the frontal lobes experience is available to everybody. And that it's very simple, it's very automatic, it is genetically encoded to happen, that all you have to do is merely release your inhibitors, which usually are nothing more than child traumas, and then the genetic code zaps it forward from the back of your head into the front of your head, and then you can call it whatever you want, nirvana, satori, born again. It's the next step in the evolution. But it can be done free. You don't have to go to any expert. You don't have to go to any charismatic character. I am the way. Follow me. You do it yourself. Okay. Now, if it's a do-it-yourself process, then that means that we can give it away. We can give it away to all the labor unions. We can give it away to all the schools. We can give it away to all the women's clubs, to the Catholic Church, to every denomination of the Protestant Church, so that everyone can add their own rite, R-I-T-E, to it, and their own procedures, and still come out with the jackpot. The main rule to follow is, don't take yourself so damn seriously. Now, I see my own function as being partially showbiz. That the role of the leader is to help people make the transition from their fear into their desire to grow up. And the way to do this is to make education entertaining. I started out as Lingo the Drifter, the balladeer from the mountains, and used that in order to get this mountain here. And anybody who comes up on this hill here knows that we all put our pants on one leg at a time. Well, some of us don't. but just to be a charismatic, to say, follow me, there is no way but me, that's bullshit. We don't know what the way is. We're all blundering in our own way. So this essentially is what I'm doing here, is just helping people find out that they are the way, because your way is not my way, and my way surely is not your way.
Rye, whiskey, whiskey, I cried. If I don't get some whiskey, well, I think I will die. Well, it's a beefsteak when I'm hungry, rye whiskey when I'm dry. A greenbacks when I'm hard up, and religion when I die.
Come on, can you harmonize?
Can I harmonize? Oh. I'm just waiting for somebody to ask me.
Jack the Diamond. Pockets of silver and gold. If the ocean was whiskey and I was a duck, I'd be back at the bottom and never come home.
Ow, bow, beetle, bottle, bottle, beetle, bow, bow, bow.
My name is T.D. Lingo. T.D.A. Lingo. Theocharis Doka Anthropotis Lingo. And the reason I am here is because I have gone to 4 different universities asking the same question. Why did I have to kill my brother during the war? And the answers always came out the same. It has to do something with human motivation, and human motivation originates in the brain, and the research hasn't been done yet, so you'd better get out of here, out of this university, and go do it yourself. So I did. Went out and figured, if I'm going to do research, got to have a place to do it. Wanted a little top of the mountain. Said, well, ain't got no money for it, can't buy it. So God, if you ain't pretty, you better be smart. So I knew 9 folk songs and 3 chords on a guitar, and one of my girlfriends wrote a letter to Groucho Marx and said, hey, there's this fellow out here in Colorado you ought to talk to. So I ended up on Groucho Marx's program, You Bet Your Life. We had a good time singing about raw whiskey, raw whiskey, raw whiskey, I cried. Yeah, don't get raw whiskey, I surely will die. Good Lord, hell!
Well, there's folk songs for chilling, too, and there's folk songs when you got the wide smile across your face and...
What are you doing here?
So from there, they took me to New York City and put me on another TV show, and they're paying me $2,000 an hour. Tried to talk them into letting me work a 40-hour week.
they wouldn't let me. So after the summer replacement series was over, well, then I cashed my check. I didn't trust them, and got two paper shopping bags full of $20 bills and came out to Colorado and shopped around and found out you could buy a whole mountain for that amount of money. Gave one of the shopping bags to the Internal Revenue Service. So that was back in 1957, and retired then, and been doing research since then, which is 22 years, and just got this raw piece of land up here, in the beginning, and since that time, well, there have been about 30 of us that have been doing primary research on different phases of the brain revolution. We're doing the applied behavioral phase up here.
The students that come up here during the summer course are participants and learners. All you bring is your sleeping bag and an axe, and then live out in a lean-to, split your own firewood, enjoy life, get right back to the primal impulses of being yourself within the life force.
I love it. I wake up in the middle of the night and I see the stars out here. In the morning, maybe a deer comes walking by down in front. My favorite kind of butterflies are twittering by all day long while I'm making my breakfast. And it's nice. In fact, it's hard to come down sometimes.
Oh, it's very different being in primal nature than from being in the city. In the city, there is no silence. I mean, up here, of course, we have the jets too, but there's a much different atmosphere. No TVs, no radios. None of all those distractions that people are used to. You're really faced with yourself.
The thing for me about being in primal nature is that it is the one place where I can sit down and feel love. When I'm in the city, I cannot sit down and feel love. I feel nervous and like I'm being attacked from all sides, whereas when I'm out in nature, I sit down and just, it's like, oh, yeah.
That the great thing about the group is that everyone's here working on their therapy, everyone's trying to grow up, and so it keeps you going. It's like, we're a family, we're going to encourage you to get through the pain and be here to help you. So that's really great. It's not like a negative peer pressure, but a positive support group.
Misery loves company.
It's been very good for me, for my growth, too. It's the only thing I've found so far that seems to be the answer for me. I followed a couple of gurus and decided that was an endless trail. I've been investigating for a long time.
I've done a little transactional analysis and reevaluation counseling. I've done transcendental meditation. And none of those related anything that was happening inside me to my brain. Lingo was the only person who could explain to me what was going on, what was happening in my brain, and that it was something that I should encourage.
He's the best teacher I've ever had, the only real teacher I've ever had. He has an incredible insight into people, just seeing where you're at and to coming up with just the precise gimmick or the precise word or action to help you break through.
He probably has personality traits that put a lot of people off. He's purposely abrasive sometimes. He doesn't want a lot of kids hanging around at his feet insisting that he be a big daddy. He will only play that trip in so far as it's necessary for your therapy, and after that, forget it.
You know how I make cowboy coffee? What you do is you take 1 pound of coffee, see, and you grind it up between two rocks, and then you pour it into an old tin can, then you add a little bit of water to it and boil it over a roaring fire, and you take a horseshoe and you throw it in, and if the horseshoe sinks, you add more coffee.
As you self-circuit into more of your dormant brain tissue, you compute more thought. as you compute more thought residue is left over, thought garbage. Now, this garbage must be excreted. The way you excrete it is through multiple orgasm.
When I had 80 orgasms, I was doing incredibly tense therapy. So I had all this excess shit that would have been channeled back into my neuroses. So it's just speeding up of therapy. I think that the unusual multiple orgasm is in the male as opposed to in the female. I think a lot of females have multiple orgasms, but I don't think that they have them to the extent that they could have them, which is, you know, 200 in a row.
When you're talking about males having 100 or 200 multiple orgasms, then the question always comes, my God, how many gallons? Okay, the male multiple orgasm, which has not yet been measured by electroencephalograms, and which shortly should be, with one connector on the prostatic urethra. In other words, you have to shove it up your ass in order to get an accurate reading. There are two parts to the male multiple orgasm. First is the reproductive part, just to ejaculate the semen, and that takes approximately 45 seconds. And then after that, it turns into a pure electro consciousness type of driving. There are different individuals can imagine their different kinds of curves. There is the driver that goes bang, 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 just on and on and on and on, and just goes more and more screams, end up being completely hoarse for the next day or two. And then there is another kind, which is a healer, which is a slow rise and a slow decline and a slow rise and a slow decline.
Explain the difference that the function of the shit out has between a driver and a...
Well, okay, now this is what we're hypothesizing, is that you can predict on any one day what your orgasm is going to be the next day. If you are doing a certain kind of thought production, whether it be a defensive, competitive consciousness thought production, then predictably you will have drivers. If you are doing loving, creative work, then predictably the next day you will have healers. The point is that multiple orgasm, especially for males, more easily for females, is now teachable.
With all my money, going to town to see my honey. Come a tie-eye, whoop-a-la-yoo, whoop-a-yip-a-yee. With the news in the saddle and the seat in the sky, quit punching cattle in the sweet by-and-by. Come a tie-eye, whoop-a-la-yip-a-yee, whoop-a-yip-a-yee. Oh, come along, boys, and listen to my teal as I tell you of my troubles and the old chisel trail. Come a tie-eye, whoop-a-la-yip-a-yee, tie-eye, whoop.
How do I do it? What is the methodology by which one gets this brain dormancy release? Okay, number one, it starts with the facts of your brain. This can be transmitted either through a complicated neurology book or intermediary through some of the simple texts that we've created up here, or even down to the level of comic books for the poor people, for the uneducated. Secondly, learn meditation. Now, old-time meditation has been like looking at the TV test pattern and saying, my, isn't that pretty? But forgetting that there are some channels you can click over into. So what we have discovered up here is that meditation is a form of concentrating energy so that you can laser this energy into certain portions of your brain, specifically into the hippocampus, which is in the limbic lobes. And by lasering meditation into your hippocampus, you release what you thought were repressed memories of your childhood traumas. Once these come up, then they can be dealt with. Third thing, you then learn a simple method of simple psychodrama, acting it out. Whenever you have a child trauma, merely by acting it out, it then discharges the emotion.
Randolph! You bad boy! You broke this carnation! You're bad! I hate you! I hate you so much, I want to kill you!
I hate you! The basic therapy is to get back to your child. Each of us has child memories that were usually between age 1 and 6 that are stored in our brains. And these were traumas, and they cause blocks in your brain. If you can get back, re-experience the trauma, act it out, then go through dominating the parent, dominating the trauma, and then changing it in your brain into a positive memory, then you're rid of the negative. And it's no longer a block in your brain.
There's no love.
This is self-therapy, and the reason it works is because you know all the specifics and all the details of your own problems, and you can spend an entire lifetime like Woody Allen going to a psychiatrist and paying him and never really solving your problems. It's one thing to talk about your problems, it's another thing to defuse them completely and check them out.
You cocksucker! How can you do that?
I should break your fucking neck, you compulsive bastard! You're so concerned I keep my room straight! You don't give a shit about what I learned, how I feel! You don't give a shit about me, you hate me! You're so fucking stupid! How can you call yourself a parent?
People are looking for the answer to life. And the answer is between each set of ears, washed or unwashed. Merely release the frontal lobes, you automatically get group telepathy, you automatically get advanced intelligence, you get whole brain power. It's power. The power in your own head. Take it. And then once you take it, higher reality. This lower reality is a pain in the ass.
Here we go.
I've sung this song, but I'll sing it again. All the people I know and the places I've been, of all the good people that I've left behind, there's really no part that's bothered my mind singing songs. the churches was packed, and the dusty old dust storm was blowing the black. The preacher couldn't see a word.